I'll tell you something very interesting, brother. Yeah. Even though I had reserved it as a dialogue and as an anecdote for a script of mine, and I've written it in it.
Yeah.
There's a city in Rajasthan, a town rather, called Byawar.
Byawar.
I don't know if I Byawar. Mm-hmm. Now, I was like, yeah, in Mewadi, in Marwadi, because these are the predominant languages in Rajasthan. I was like, there's no word such as this. And anyone and everyone, even the elders I went to, though, you know, in the village, I was like, what does the word Byawar mean? Like Jaipur means something because it's named after Maharaja Jai Singh.
Hmm.
Pur means city, Nagar. I'm like, what is Byawar? So I met this really old chacha somewhere at a pan store. Okay. And he told me something very interesting. He was like, basically that belt between Jaipur and Byawar basically is a small town that falls in that Ajmer district.
Yeah.
Which is in between Jaipur and Udaipur.
Hmm.
Basically, now that was a dacoit prone area.
Right.
Now, dacoits were basically during the British Raj.
Yeah.
Either you had revolutionaries who were out there and you know, who were self-proclaimed krantikaris and freedom fighters, and they were literally fighting for India's freedom selflessly. And okay, then there was the common man who was working in the British Indian, you know, administrations, or you know, they were just living under the rule and they were not doing anything about it, which was the majority, which Gandhi mobilized, which is why Gandhi is great. But I don't agree that he's a Mahatma. That's a different topic. But and then there was a class which were dacoits. They were like, we'll become outlaws, we don't give a fuck.
Yeah,
we just want to fend for ourselves and we want to live luxurious lives, and the system has failed us. To hell with everyone, to hell with the zamindars, to hell with the elite, to hell with everyone. So they were outlaws.
Mm.
Now, if you go to Chambal right now, Chambal, which is where Gabbar Singh's character is based, there's barely any dacoits left.
Yeah.
Okay, because they have been replaced by organized crime and mafia and the underworld. Mm. Okay. So basically, they have no relevance right now in 2020 as we speak. Now, when you speak of Gabbar Singh, it's very interesting. Because I remember watching this interview of this director, Mr. Shekhar Kapoor, who's made films like Mr. India and Bandit Queen.
Yeah.
Now, he says that when they were shooting Bandit Queen in Chambal, and they were shooting it exactly in that terrain, okay, so some dacoits actually landed up on the set.
Yeah.
And they were like, "Arre, kaha hai ki ghode pe kyun hai ye bhai, daku tumhare?" To bolte, but in reality, talking about reality, dacoits were never on horseback. There are no horses in Chambal. It was just a glorified representation of dacoits being on horseback, since you mentioned a Hollywood influence coming from the Wild West.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, and I guess so, also it's also making them seem more intimidating, right? You don't want, like, the actual picture of a dacoit is this individual is living in poverty. And the reason this person is kind of resorting to like these kinds of behaviors, like robbing and all, I'm not justifying the fact that they're acting that way, but you still need to understand where they come from. And they come from a space which is oppressed to a certain extent by the systems that society had set up since God knows when.
Wait, I forgot to tell you about Byawar. I sort of
died. Oh, yeah.
So basically, so that old man told me that how the name Byawar came about. So he was like, when the Brits came here, there was nothing here. There was no civilization. And still, the population density in Rajasthan is not that much. So they just put up a board saying, be aware, there are dacoits. So then once the British established a cantonment, so the locals started inhabiting that space. So they could not pronounce be aware. So over these, it's become be aware, be aware, be aware.
What the fuck? Are you serious? Dude, that's nuts, man.